Hey guys, today I'm gonna do Love and Hip Hop Miami, season one, episode, I don't know, I think it's seven, eight, nine, I don't know. It's not, I'm disappointed in this season because it's not what we thought it was gonna be. That's why what happens when we always getting pumped up for new shit, and then it ain't what we thought it was gonna be. But with that being said, we'll get on to it. Before I do, shout out to DMG Radio with the D-Barn Show. If you have not watched my Love and Hip Hop New York video, I'm shouting her out again in this video because she did her launch show tonight on Blog Talk Radio, and she's going to give me an opportunity to be under her and start my It's All About Support Radio starting on, I think it's the 16th. No, we changed the date. So I'll get the dates to you because we did change the dates, but it will be like within the next 2 weeks that I will be starting my show following her show. But next Friday, I will be doing my pre-show for It's All About Support so I can get my feet wet. And then that following Tuesday, you know how to do Support Tuesday, then I'm gonna do my It's All About Support for that. And it's gonna be every Tuesday at 9 o'clock Pacific Coast time. So maybe what is six at six some of y'all time, seven some of y'all time. Just to know, mine is gonna be 9 Pacific Coast time. So yes, every Tuesday, we will be doing that, and then at 8 o'clock it will be the D Barn Show. So you can go click on her show at 8 o'clock, and then right after hers, mine's gonna kick in. So you ain't gotta go nowhere. Just saying. Anyway, let's get into this review. We gonna just talk about everybody and one thing. I ain't going step by step, so I can hurry up and go to bed. It's 11:29 p.m. I gotta be up at 3:45 a.m. So I'm tired. Baby Blue and Scrappy meet up at the gym to talk about catching up. They fake worked out, and now they catching up or whatever. They talked about Chinese Nikki and her daughter and yada yada yada, and Scrappy working with them, whatever. Then he talked about Shay. They brought up Shay because Blue said that he was working with Shay. And then he was like, "Well, she mad at me for working with Chinese Nikki and her daughter." And then he brought up how Shay, Blue brought up how Shay, how he met Shay was through P because she was dating P at the time, but they not dating no more. Scrappy was looking like, "What the hell? I didn't know that. She didn't tell me she had a boyfriend." So he was like, "Well, she having this boot camp thing. You need to come by to her event. Ruin it. It don't matter. Even though I do branding and I'm helping this girl brand, I'm going to bring some mess to her brand." I didn't understand that. I would have cussed his ass out too. So when they do the boot camp, they all working out. Michelle Pooch is there because she's frustrated from some shit that happened with her. So she needs to release her frustration. They all working out, having fun. Afterwards, Scrappy walk in. She like, "What the fuck is he doing there?" He walk up. She like, "What are you doing here?" He like, "Well, I was invited by Blue because you didn't invite me." She was like, "Why would I? I don't fuck with you no more. Why would I invite you after you don't have no loyalty to me because you're hanging with the little ugly broads?" So she was like, "Well, I don't mean to call them ugly. I don't want to go on nobody looks. You know, the girls, they just rub me the wrong way." And so he like, "Man, like, you tripping." So they going back and forth. She cussing him out. He looking at her like, "Bitch, you crazy." He talking about, "I don't need you. I don't want to be here. Yada, yada, yada." But I'm like, "You came. You came. And she didn't invite you, but you still came." So then Blue is trying to, I don't know if Blue trying to get them together, back together, trying to get Scrappy to just smash, trying to make Pleasure P mad. But I'm like, you have no loyalty to your homeboy. That's for damn sure. That is for damn sure. It's one thing to make money with Shay, but it's a whole nother motherfucking thing to get your homeboy or brother or whatever he is to you ex-girlfriend with the next motherfucker. No, on national TV. That's some salty ass shit if I ever seen it. Like, no. So they going back and forth, then they end up making up, but kind of not making up. She like, I hope you have a good life, yada yada yada, whatever. She walks away, and I'm like, y'all need to talk or be together any goddamn way. Michelle Pooch has an event because she's gonna release a new horrible single that she got out. Even when they start fucking playing her single, I was glad that Prince had interrupted that shit. I was like, what the fuck? But okay. But before that happened, Malika's there. He tells Simply Just that he came out. She like, good shit. More power to your ass. He's so excited that he's out now. Up until Prince comes up in there doing his little, I don't know. He sent some people in there to do some kind of little Vogue, whatever bullshit they were doing, and homegirl was trying to stop them. They wouldn't stop. He laughing. She tells Malik, gets mad at her. She like, I didn't do this shit. He did this shit. So he goes over there and goes off on him like, why the fuck would you do this when I'm here? What are you thinking? And I'm like, bitch, this don't got nothing to do with you. He like, I didn't know you were gonna be here. And he just really going off on him, talking about, I got a brand and I got this and I got that. And I'm like, because you there in a building with gay people, it's gonna fuck you up. But I don't understand his logic. The way he talk about gays, I don't understand. I don't like him. Don't bring these motherfuckers, Mona. Don't bring these motherfuckers back next season. Him and the other boy that was messing with Amara. Don't bring these motherfuckers back. Young Hollywood. Don't bring these back. Don't bring no dude that's been blatantly racist on your show back. Don't bring a dude that's been so homophobic back on your show when you know that's your audience. It's offensive. I don't give a fuck. Like, this dude is so fucked up. Like, I don't give a fuck if he fighting his demons in the inside. He fighting what he wants to be. No, I don't care. You don't have to fucking do that to tear down other people and talk about other people. And that's what he do. I don't fuck with him. Speaking of him, whatever. I don't care. I'm gonna talk about him again in a minute. So yeah, I talked about that. Talk about that. Trick Daddy now have this. If I have to get anything else, I'm just gonna go into the whole Bobby Lights thing and Trina, and then I'm gonna go back a little bit back on Malik, and that's it. So if I miss something else, I don't care. Anyway, Trick Daddy and Super Cindy, Super Messy. They have this podcast and they're interviewing Bobby Lights and Miami Tip. And well, Miami Tip is just there to support Bobby Lights. And they're talking about his music. They play his song Way Up and Trick Daddy like go up to him. He like, you're a good artist, you're a good writer, I support you, and all that kind of stuff. Trick Daddy was with it. So, they was talking about him being a openly gay rapper, and he was like, I'd rather talk about it than somebody I come out rapping and then they start questioning me about it. So I might as well just put it out there so that nobody had nothing to say. I'm totally with that. I just don't want all your songs to just be about that, because then I'll be like, bitch, it's just like everything else. And it's not even having nothing to do with him having sex or talking about sex with a dude. I don't give a shit about that. I love my LGBT community that be talking about what they do, and I love how ratchet it be. But I just feel like, why bring out something that's gonna be like everybody else? I'm just saying. I'm gonna give you a perfect example, and it's not like everybody else, but a person that's seen a gay man that sings good music. I love the fucking song. Sashawn Bradley got a goddamn song called Liquor Like a Cone, and I go hard for that song. When he dropped that song, I hurried up and got it. I love that song. So I'm just saying. So don't think that because he's gay, I won't support the song. No, fuck that. That song, Liquor Like a Cone by Sashawn Bradley, I'm telling you, that shit is the bomb. So, anyway, after Trick Daddy end up leaving early, And they're still sitting there with this damn messy ass other broad. And she asked him about Trina and in their relationship, they're being family and her not supporting him. And he started going off about Trina not supporting him. So Miami Tip is just like, what have you done for her? She started defending Trina basically. Like, what have you shown her? Where have you brought her where she can, support your music? Just asking him questions like, but you are not gonna throw Trina under the bus, knowing I'm sitting here, knowing I work for her, open up for her, whatever the case may be. She have gave me opportunities, not gonna happen. So he looking, he's taken aback by the shit, cause he like, bitch, you supposed to be my homegirl and you defending my cousin. And after old girl walks away, he kind of confronts her about it, and she rips him a fucking new one. She rips him a new one, and you can tell that he felt bad and he felt her pain and he knew where she was coming from because he didn't go off and be extra with her, but you can tell all in his face that he was like, oh fuck, I kind of fucked up. I kind of fucked up. And because her emotions was there, you saw her emotions just as well, because she like, I take care of you, I take care of my son, my family, everybody. I came from a strip club, so it's harder for me to people to take me serious, and this is what I do. So for somebody to give me the opportunity, and then you gonna shit on them in front of in an interview that I'm sitting in on, that it can be taken wrong. You kind of put her in a fucked up situation. Then she feels like you so mad about Trina not supporting you when I'm giving you 150,000% for support, and you're not even acknowledging that. You use her studio for free. She's probably doing all kind of other shit. She's there with you in the studio right now, supporting your interview, and you have not once said boo. Thank you for all your support, but he's so busy worried about his famous cousin not supporting him. Get over that. So then he has this release party for his song Way Up. Everybody's there. Before the party, he did send Trina and Joy an invite. So Joy asked Trina to go. She said, I'll think about it. They talked about that boy that she said she don't know. I don't know if they dating. Don't care. So they go to the party and support Bobby. He happy that everybody is there to support him. You got this, what's her name? Super Cindy. You got Miami Tip. All of them is there. Before the party, Miami Tip did go to Jeffrey and ask him to come and support him and let bygones be bygones or whatever. So he said he'll see if he'll come, whatever. So she go, everybody is sitting there in a VIP or whatever while he's performing Way Up. Messy Super Cindy, Super Messy Cindy, that's what her name is, Super fucking Messy Cindy. She turns around and say, well, Trina, I'm surprised you here to support him after the interview and him talking. Trina like, bitch, what are you talking about? What interview? So she tells her what was said and kind of trying to turn around. And Miami Tip, she must have got Miami Tip was sitting there because she was like, wait, hold up, slow up. That ain't what was said. This is what was said. So she kind of threw his ass under the bus, too. But hell, she said what it was because Trina's going to hear the goddamn interview. So now Trina's mad. Trina, like, let me go confront him real quick. Let me hold on real quick. And I'm like, bitch, you messy. That bitch is messy as hell. I understand you're a vlogger, whatever, podcaster. I understand. So you try to get the scoop. But bitch, you were really, really fucked up in that situation. And I hope everybody rips you a new one on the blogger scene for being fucking messy. But Trina goes and confronts him and it goes left because Trina asks him about the blog or whatever, and he tried to defend himself about the way he responded. And they just start going back and forth about him being a star. No, you're not on my level. You're beneath me. That type of shit. I was irritated with both of them. I was irritated with the way she was responding. No, he's not on Trina's level. No, he's not. But at the same time, stop. Humble yourself, Trina. Humble your fucking self. Now, I get it. Don't use her name to, get these interviews going. You don't need her name to blow up, none of that type of shit. And Bobby, you're not the star you think you are. Both of y'all, maybe it runs in y'all family. Maybe that's what it is. It runs in y'all family. Just saying. Y'all need to humble yourself. But it was stupid. It was stupid. They family, they going at it. But I heard they get along now. So why am I going off on both of them if they're going to fucking get along? That's stupid. So after they leave, Jeffrey comes. Jeffrey comes and so Bobby back excited. He back excited because first he was fit to go off on Miami tip. Like, what did y'all tell Trina that she's so mad at me? And I'm looking like, bitch, what? Why would you think she told? Well, maybe because she defended Trina. But so he happy Jeffrey's there. They flirt with each other. They say, let's bygones be bygones or whatever. And they flirting. And I'm sitting there like, Jeffrey, you forgot you was with Malik now? Did you forget? I'm like, he's a whole motherfucking man whore. He's a whole man whore. Whoever gives him dick that night, that's who he gonna take up the offer, because you was in a relationship with Bobby. Then you start cheating on him with Malik. Now you with Malik, and now you want to cheat back with Bobby? Like, your whole man fucking whore. And then when you get caught out on your shit, you like, ooh, what did I do? Ooh, try to play the victim. Like, oh, I ain't got time for this shit. You's a whole bitch for that. So he goes back to Malik's house and he notices his bags is packed the fuck up. You about to get the fuck out. So Malik start going off. I came out for you. Hold on, y'all. So he was like, I came out for you, yada, yada, yada. And I'm just like, here we go. Here we go with Malik bullshit. Malik, stop blaming people. You didn't come out. Well, you wanted to be with him, but it seemed like you were already out. Maybe your family knew. They just ain't said nothing. But I just hate, like, the way he tried to come at Malik about him coming out. I just don't like him. I think he a whole asshole. They don't need to be together because Jeffrey is a man whore. He ain't gonna be faithful to neither one of they ass. Do we need a place to stay? Where the fuck is his house? Because it seemed like last time he was in the room when Bobby came to see him. Now you're staying at homeboy house and your shit packed up. Like, where the fuck you live at? Well, I'm just saying. Anyway, y'all tell me what y'all thought. I didn't think this video was gonna be this long, but I'm about to go to bed anyway. It's almost midnight and I gotta get up too early. I'm tired. Y'all tell me what y'all thought about it. It was a whole mess and a half. Like I said, this season have not done it for me like I thought it was gonna be. But we'll talk next week when it goes down with Amara and Veronica, I guess. Follow me on all social media sites by The Ghetto View, THA, not THE. And don't forget, I will be launching two new shows on Blog Talk Radio. One would be Inside About Support Radio, will be off of DMG Radio. And I will be doing that. And then I will be doing The Ghetto View Radio. And that will be doing my Ghetto Views on Friday. But the Inside About Support show will be on Tuesdays because I do support Tuesdays for artists. And then on Fridays I can do all my topics of the week on a Friday, so, and do my Ghetto Views like that. So that will be up. Also, my sister will be in town this weekend with my crazy family, so I will be going live on all my social media sites, but I'm gonna try to go live on YouTube with my sister so we could do a My Ghetto Views this weekend and talk about all the crazy shit. Maybe we'll talk about Safari. I don't too much care, but she might care. Black China, she might care. I don't care. All the people, Monique. I'm just saying, I'll talk about it. I'm going to talk about it this Friday. Even if she don't do the video with me, I will be going live this Friday, hopefully by 5 p.m. Pacific Coast Standard Time. So I don't know if it's 7 or 8 in some of y'all cities. So around that time, I will be going live on Friday. So make sure you guys tune in for My Ghetto Views. And I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Peace.